Let's get started with the Go With The Flow shawl. This is a skein I'm using, Alice Angora Gold, color 4686. We need only one skein. It's pink with greenish in it. It's a really beautiful color. So we're crocheting, Tunis crocheting the shawl today, and it will be a fluffy shawl, so loose crocheting with a big hook. It has a Tunisian knit stitch and a yarn around. So we start off with a chain of 45 chains, and I'm using a Tunis crochet hook size 4.5 millimeters. It is approximately 30 centimeters long, this hook. No need for a longer hook. This is really lace yarn, so you're using a big hook in compared to the yarn itself. With Tunisian crochet, you take always one hook, at least one hook, full hook size bigger than the yarn recommends. So when the label says 4 millimeter, a 3 millimeter hook, use a 4.5 per example. So let's get started. I start with a chain on my hook and I tie up that chain so that chain won't go loose anymore. So here it is. And now we start chaining 45 chains. So it's number one, number two, and crochet loosely. Don't put that much tension on the yarn itself. So make sure you crochet loosely throughout this whole pattern. It's number nine, number 10. Well, continue up until you have 45 chains. And then we start with a Tunisian simple stitch. And then we start with the basic stitch for this pattern. Well, I crocheted the 45 chains. This will be crocheting in the width of the shawl, but we crochet up until we have a really long piece that we crocheted. So we start with putting your hook into the second chain from your hook. So don't count your loop on the hook. And here is the second loop. Put your hook through, pick up the yarn and pull up. Like a single crochet, only with a single crochet yarn around to pull through again. We don't do that. We leave the loops on the hook. So this is two loops on the hook. Yarn around and pull through again. So you've got three loops on the hook. Put your hook in the next stitch, yarn around and pull up. Now you've got four loops on the hook. Put your hook through one loop, the next loop, and yarn around and pull up. This is what you're doing throughout this row. So stick your hook through and pull up the loop. Make sure you crochet loosely. Don't put much tension on it. At the end, you will have 45 loops on your hook. And then we start finishing off this row, because one row Tunisian crochet is row with picking up loops and taking the loops off your hook. So keep on continuing up until you're in the last chain. So stick through, pull up the loop, and this is all you're doing throughout this beginning of this row. Make sure you crochet with even tension, but loosely. So, like this. Crochet loosely. Put your hook through, yarn around the hook, and pull up. Take to the next loop, yarn around, and pull up. Just put your hook up, like this. Push. So I crocheted it up until the last stitch. Here it is. Stick your hook through and pull up. Now I've got 45 chains on my hook. 45 loops on my hook, sorry. Here it is. The first chain here is a chain we do count as a stitch, only you don't crochet it. I will get back to that one. Move it up a bit. Now, to get an even edge on this side, first you make yarn around and pull through one loop only. So this is the first stitch. Hold that stitch with your finger so that way it stays loosely. in the second row you need the same stitch. I will show you again. So we start first with, hold it here, make sure it's loosely, pick up the yarn and pull through one loop here. Hold that stitch with your fingers and yarn around, and now we go through two loops. So that is up to the last stitch. That is through your working loop that you just pulled through and through one loop from the hook. Hold the stitch, yarn around and pull through your working loop and through the loop from the hook. So every time through two loops. So here's the first and the second loop. Make sure you put your hook facing downwards, otherwise you will stuck in your loops. So yarn around and pull through two. Yarn around and pull through two. Now you continue like this up until you have only one loop left on your hook, and that is your working loop. This loop, that will be the last loop that you have left over after you're done here. So yarn around and pull through your working loop and through the loop from the hook, and so on up until you have only your working chain on your, so your working loop on your hook. So I will speed up a bit. So I'll push up a bit of work, and you continue like this, pull through two, pull through two, pull through two, pull through two, up until you have one loop left. Make sure you crochet loosely and with the same tension, otherwise you have problems in the second row with putting your hook through the loops. So this is a really trying to crochet loosely, that's really important. If it's harsh for you, then go up in hook size. Then you make bigger loops automatically. So I will continue here, and then we start with the first row for the pattern. So one more. So here's my working loop. So I've got one loop on the hook, and we start with the first row, the second row. The first loop is even to the first stitch. So this here is on top of each other. We don't crochet, but we do count them. So like this, they stay just straight above each other. So if you crochet in the first stitch, you will see that you go diagonal, but we don't want the one with even edge. So this will be this stitch, equal to this stitch. I will start with a Tunisian knit stitch. Well, if you see the first, actually the second stitch, you will see a front leg and a back leg. Here is the front and there is the back. We go between those two legs to the stick to the hook through the back, like this. So that will be the Tunisian knit stitch. So if you can't knit but you love to knit stitch, this is the easy way to crochet it. So here is the front and the back, and between them you go through all the way to the back. So let's start. Here's the stitch, the front leg, and we stick the hook through the back, pick up the yarn and pull up the loop, and we leave it like this. That's all. Here's the second stitch. I will pick it up here. Here it is. A little leg front and a little leg at the back, and you stick your hook between those two legs through the back. Yarn around and pull up the loop, and leave it loosely on your crochet hook. So here's the next. Between the two legs, stick your hook through the back and pull up. Now I've got four loops on the hook. Here's this next loop. From the front to the back, pick up the yarn and pull up the loop. This is for this row only to do. So here's the next stitch, front and the back leg, stick through, pick up the yarn and pull up. Well, This row will be continuing like this up until you're at the end, and then we finish off the last stitch together, because that's a little bit different than this one. It will be a Tunisian knit stitch, only we're at the edge of the shawl, and then your stitch will be a little bit hidden on the sides, on the side of this row. So crochet loosely, that's really important, otherwise you have problems in the next row to put your hook through. So I will speed up a bit and then I'll show you what to do with the last stitch. So I put my turbo hook on. I'm going a little bit faster now. If you want to see it again, just wind back and play again, or put it on pause button. So one row of Tunisian crochets, one row of putting up the loops, and run and backwards taking off the loops. That is one row. So I'm almost there. Here, there's a couple of stitches more. Here one, the next. Almost there. This is so fun doing Tunisian crochet. Once you have the feeling, you want to do more and more and more Tunisian crochet projects. But we were going to continue more things with crocheting Tunisian. So I'm at the last two stitches now, and you already see, you can already see the knit stitch. Here's the second and last stitch. So here you continue with the normal Tunisian knit stitch, and then we're at the edge. If you turn your work a little bit forward, you will see here a little V. Well, you put your hook under underneath the two loops, yarn around and pull up. So this is the first part of the second row. Now we start with taking off the loop. So again, pull through one loop, hold that stitch together, and this will be repeating throughout the whole project. So, and then pull through two, and pull through two. So that's the same as the first row. First you go through one loop, and then you go through two loops, two loops, two loops, and so on, up until you have one loop left on your hook. That will be your working loop, working chain, or loop, how you want to call it. Pull through two, and pull through two, and pull through two. So taking off the stitches go faster, and when it's the first time you Tunisian crochet, then take your time, because in the beginning it will go slow, but eventually when you get the hang of it, it will go so really fast. You can make everything with Tunisian crochet. You can make a blanket, you can make hand shoes, hand gloves, you can make cardigans, sweaters, you can make really everything from with Tunisian crochet. So here a little bit slow motion to show you how to take off the loops. Here it is. And more. Yarn around and pull through two, and pull through two, and so on. Well, I'm almost there. And one more, and voila. Here it is. And you already see, starting to see the Tunisian crochet stitch, the knit stitch. So when you're not sure, I am planning on making the Tunisian knit stitch a separate tutorial for that, but later on. So we start with the third row. Now we start with the Tunisian knit stitch like the row before, and do remember, this chain will be equal to the first stitch, so we don't crochet that. We go into the second stitch between the two legs from the front to the back. And two more times. So here's the next stitch through the back and pull up. It's number three. And here is number four. So four knit stitches in the beginning. Now we start with a yarn around and then a Tunisian knit stitch. So yarn around. That will be equal to the knit stitch below. So that's actually just the next stitch. And you skip that one. So you go directly to the second stitch. And there you make your Tunisian knit stitch. Like this. So yarn around and knit stitch in the following stitch. So you skip one stitch and in the next stitch you make a Tunisian knit stitch. So yarn around, skip the next stitch and Tunisian knit stitch in the following stitch. So between the two legs from the front to the back, yarn around and pull up. Again, yarn around, skip a stitch, and in the next stitch you make a Tunisian knit stitch. So put your hook from the front to the back between the two legs and pull up the loop. Yarn around, skip a stitch, and go into the next stitch with a Tunisian knit stitch. Yarn around, skip a stitch, this one, and in the following stitch you make your Tunisian knit stitch. Like this. Yarn around, skip a stitch, and in the following stitch you make your Tunisian knit stitch. One more time, yarn around, skip the next stitch, and in the following stitch you make your Tunisian knit stitch. Like this. And pull up. Well, this will be continuing up until you have four stitches left on the left side here. And we'll finish this first part of row three together. So yarn around, skip a stitch, and in the next stitch a Tunisian knit stitch. That's all there is, and we'll finish off together. I'll just speed up a bit here. Here it is. So yarn around. Well, I finished this round and I promised that we finish this row together. Now I need to do one more yarn around and then we have four stitches left. 1, 2, 3 and number four. And this will be your skipped stitch because we make yarn around again. Yarn around, and then in the next four stitch you make a Tunisian knit stitch. Only the last stitch will be the stitch in the edge. So here's the third knit stitch. And here is the edge again. You would turn your work a bit forward to see it. And here is the stitch. Put your hook underneath two loops and yarn around and pull up. So you've got four knit stitches in the beginning and four knit stitches on the end. And now we take off the loops. Again, yarn around and pull through one loop. Hold that stitch. So no tension on it. Yarn around and pull through two loops. Yarn around and pull through two loops. Yarn around and pull through two loops. Be careful with the yarn around that you made in the previous piece of this row, because you need to make it two. So make sure you go through two loops. So first you go up until there. So you go through your knit stitch here, and then you go through your yarn around. Knit stitch and your yarn around. And this will be the only row that you're going to be repeating throughout this project. So I finish this row a bit faster. So pull through two loops every time up until you have only one loop left on your hook, and that's your working chain, your working loop. I will speed up a bit here to show you. I'm almost there. You can always click on the pause button if you like, or rewind if you want. Take your time on this. If this is your first time you Tunisian crochet, please do take your time. Well, I'm almost there. And the last two and the last one. So here it is. I'm at the end. So here are the four normal Tunisian knit stitch. So the first stitch will be this stitch here. You don't crochet it, and you go into the second stitch. You make your Tunisian knit stitch. So put your hook between those two legs and pull up. Actually three times, and then you have four loops on your hooks. Well, now, you see a really big, like an A-shape stitch. That will be your yarn around, and here will be your knit stitch. So we first yarn around, and then we go directly to the knit stitch, and there you make your knit stitch. This is to be repeated throughout this whole pattern. So big A shape, that's yarn around, so you yarn around, and then you go to the knit stitch and you make your knit stitch. Yarn around and a knit stitch in the knit stitch. Yarn around and go to the knit stitch and make your knit stitch. So this will be repeated throughout this complete shawl up to the last couple of rows, but we get back to that in the second part. And we're going to make the long shawl together into a infinity or a Mobius shawl, that's up to you. So we continue a bit faster, and then we finish off this row together one more time, because the last four stitches are the knit stitches and you don't do a yarn around in that particular area. So I'm at the end. I've got my last yarn around, and here are my four knit stitches. That's included the stitch in the border, so in the edge of the shawl. Here's my first knit stitch, my second knit stitch, and my third knit stitch, and then we are at the edge. Here is the corner here stitch. And put your hook underneath the two loops. Yarn around and pull up. And now you take off the yarn again, the loops again. So pull through one loop at the border, hold that stitch, and pull through two loops, and pull through two loops, yarn around, pull through two loops. Oh, now it went through three loops, it should be two, so two. So this will be only repeated throughout this part. The skein is about 550 meters long. So keep on crocheting up until you have a couple of grams left. And then we start finish off this shawl and sewing it together into an infinity or a Mobius shawl. That's up to you. So repeat this row. Four knit stitches, and then yarn around, knit, and you end off with four knit stitches, included the stitch in the edge. And then take off the stitches by pulling through one loop, and then pull through two, and pull through two, and so on, and so on. Well, continue, and we'll see you in the second part of this tutorial. So have fun, and we'll see you later. Well, now you see all those V-shaped stitches on top of each other here. And that's what we're going to create throughout this whole shawl. You will see it will go a bit diagonal, but that's no problem. That's just the way the shawl must be. So, you see the Tunisian knit stitch and you see your yarn arounds. Because you take off the loops on the right side of the shawl, that's way the shawl will go a bit diagonal. You can always block the shawl afterwards, but it's not needed because we are going to make it a Mobius or an infinity, and then it's stuck together. So have fun.